Good morning, students. Today we will solve problems on multi-stage amplifiers and feedback amplifiers. Here, problem first one. A cascade of three identical non-interacting amplifiers has a cutoff frequencies 20 hertz and 20 kilohertz. Then calculate the lower and upper cutoff frequencies of individual amplifiers. So in this problem, they cascade the three non-interacting amplifiers are cascaded. Yes, and the overall cutoff frequencies of cascading amplifier, they have given lower cutoff frequency as 20 hertz and upper cutoff frequency as 20 kilohertz. Yes, in this problem we need to find out the each amplifier lower cutoff frequency and upper cutoff frequency. Yes, the three are identical, so if we calculated one amplifier lower cutoff frequency and upper cutoff frequency, that same will be applicable to the remaining amplifiers also. Yes. So, how many amplifiers are cascaded? So, number of amplifiers cascaded are 3. Here, n equals to 3. Yes. So, we can calculate individual amplifier cutoff frequency. Lower cutoff frequency equals to FL1 equals to FL into under root of 2 power 1 by n minus 1. Here, FL is the overall lower cutoff frequency. Yes, by substituting it, they have given it is equals to 20 hertz into under root of 2 power 1 by 3 minus 1. Yes, we will get approximately 10.19 hertz here. Yes, individual amplifier cutoff frequency is lower cutoff frequency is 10.19 hertz. Yes, similarly here, we need to calculate the individual amplifier upper cutoff frequency. Yes, it is FH1. Yes, so we can write FH1 equals to overall upper cutoff frequency by under root of 2 power 1 by n minus 1. Yes, here FH is the overall cutoff frequency of multi-stage amplifier. So we can write they have given it is equals to 20 kilohertz. Yes, so 20 kilohertz by 2 power 1 by 3 minus 1 will get approximately FH1 equals to 39.2 kilohertz. Yes, these are the individual amplifier lower cutoff frequency and upper cutoff frequency. Yes, next, here a multi-stage amplifier is to be constructed using 4 identical stages, each of which has lower cutoff frequency 15 hertz and upper cutoff frequency 30 kilohertz. In this first problem, what will be the lower and upper cutoff frequency of multi-stage amplifier? In the second one, if midband voltage gain of each stage is 8.2, then what will be the approximate gain of multi-stage amplifier at F equals to 7.5 hertz and at F equals to 300 kilohertz? Here, we need to calculate the overall lower cutoff frequency and overall upper cutoff frequency of multi-stage amplifier. Yes, for that, overall lower cutoff frequency, FL equals to, we can write it is equals to FL1 by under root of 2 power 1 by n minus 1. Here, how many amplifiers are cascaded? 4 identical. So, n equals to 4. So, by substituting here, we can write it is equals to FL1 is they have given as 15 hertz, 15 by under root of 2 power 1 by 4 minus 1. So we will get it is equals to 34.48 hertz. Yes. Next, overall upper cutoff frequency of multi-stage amplifier, it is given as FH. Yes. It is equals to, we can write FH1 into under root of 2 power 1 by n minus 1. So individual amplifier upper cutoff frequency they have given as 30 kilohertz into under root of 2 power 1 by 4 minus 1. By calculating you will get it is equals to 13.05 kilohertz here. Next, second problem here they mention if midband voltage gain of each stage is 8.2. What will be the approximate gain of multi-stage amplifier at 7.5 hertz and 300 kHz. So they are given the frequency f equals to 7.5 hertz and 300 kHz. So at these frequencies, we need to calculate the overall multi-stage amplifier gain by considering the individual mid-band frequency voltage gain. Yes. So we already know that overall gain is equals to individual mid-band gain by under root of 1 plus FL1 by F whole square all to the power n. Yes, when you calculate the n number. Here overall voltage gain calculated by considering the mid-band frequency and frequency. So here we have to calculate at F equals to 7.5 hertz. F equals to 7.5 hertz. Yes. So in this we can calculate AV equals to, AVM is the mid-band gain. So they have given AVM equals to how much? So they have given it is equals to 8.2. Yes. Under root of 1 plus FL1, they have given is equals to 15 by F, here it is equals to 7.5 hertz. Whole square power n, n equals to 4. Yes. So we can write it is equals to 8.2 all to the power 4 by it is 1 plus 7.5 cancel with 2 times. Yes. So here it is cancel with 2 times. So we can write n by 4, here it is equals to 4 by 2 root 2. Yes. So this is 2 times. And now we can write approximately this value equals to 179.58. Yes. Next we'll calculate the at F equals to 300 kilohertz. Yes. Again AB equals to 8.2 by under root of 1 plus. Here we have to consider the high frequency, it is 300 kilohertz. Yes. So we can write 300 kilohertz by FH1. How much FH1 is nothing but here? They are given as 30 kilohertz all square s all to the power 4. So by calculating you will get it is equals to 8.2 power 4 s 1 plus 10 square all to the power 4 by 2. Then we will get approximately 0.443. Yes. So I am writing here AV equals to AVM by under root of S 1 plus FH F by FH1 whole square power. And next we'll solve one more problem. Next we'll solve problem on feedback amplifiers. Here an amplifier has open loop gain equals to 200 and cutoff frequencies 50 hertz and 40 kHz. If 2% of output is written to the input in position, then find modified values of gain and cutoff frequencies. As here they are given the gain A equals to 200. Thus it is open loop gain. And they said if 2% of output is written to the input, that means feedback XF equals to 2% of X0. Yes. 2% of X0. So from this can we write it is equals to XF by X0 equals to 2% equals to 0.02. Yes. This XF by X0 is nothing but beta value. Yes. So your feedback factor beta equals to 0.02. So now we can calculate desensitivity D equals to 1 plus A beta. Yes. Here 1 A equals to 200 and beta equals to 0.02. We will get D equals to 1 plus A beta equals to approximately we will get it is equals to 5. Yes. 200 into 0.02 it is 4. 4 plus 1 equals to 5. Yes. So here we need to calculate the modified values of gain and cutoff frequencies. So here feedback gain equals to, here we can write AF equals to A by 1 plus A beta. Why? Because In negative amplifiers, gain is always decreases. Yes, so it is 200 by 1 plus A beta, this value equals to 5. We will get it is equals to 40. Since in negative feedback, gain decreases by 1 plus A beta times. Yes, and second one, we need to calculate the lower cutoff frequency. Here, lower cutoff frequency in feedback amplifier is decreases as it is equals to FL equals FL by 1 plus A beta. Yes, so FL is already given, it is equals to 50 edges and 1 plus A beta equals to 5, it is equals to 10 edges. Yes, and third one, upper cutoff frequency. So, upper cutoff frequency in feedback amplifier is increases FH into 1 plus A beta. Yes, so it is 40k into 5, it is equals to 200 kilohertz. Yes, since in negative feedback FLF decreases, negative feedback FHF increases. Yes, so here frequency, lower cutoff frequency is decreases by 1 by 1 plus A beta times, and upper cutoff frequency is increases by 1 plus A beta times. Yes, so in this way we can calculate the feedback amplifier gain, lower cutoff frequency and upper cutoff frequency. Yes, here one more problem. An amplifier has output voltage of 36 volts at 8% harmonic distortion when input voltage is 0.028 volts. Yes, if 1.2% of the return to the input in opposition, yes, then calculate the output voltage and harmonic distortion. Yes, so here gain is A, we can write it is equals to V0 by VA. Yes, so we know output voltage is 36 volts at 8% of harmonic distortion. Yes, at the same time input voltage is 0.028 volts. Yes, then we can calculate the voltage gain 1285.7 approximately at 8% of harmonic distortion. Yes, so we can write feedback signal XF is 1.2% of X0. Yes, if 1.2% of the output is returned to the input in a position. Yes, from this we can write XF by X0 equals to 0.012. Yes, it is nothing but beta value. Yes, beta equals to 0.012. So from this we can calculate D sensitivity equals to D equals to 1 plus A beta. Yes, 1 plus A equals to 1285.7 into beta is equals to 0.012. Yes, by simplifying we will get it is equals to 16.4. Yes, so we can write D sensitivity equals to 16.4. Yes, so here we need to calculate the output voltage and harmonic distortion. Yes, in negative feedback amplifier, gain is decreases by 1 plus A beta times. Then output also decreases by 1 plus A beta times. Yes, can we calculate the modified output? So modified output is equals to, we can write initial output by 1 plus A beta times. Yes, so that means V0 by 1 plus A beta. So initially V0 is equals to how much? Here V0 equals to 36 and 1 plus A beta value D equals to 16.4, and by calculating we will get it is equals to approximately 2.195 volts. So modified voltage equals to 2.195 volts. And next we need to calculate the harmonic distortion. Yes, so in negative feedback harmonic distortion also decreases. How much it is decreases? So in feedback amplifiers, armor distortion is decreases by 1 plus A beta times. So we can write it is equals to dH by 1 plus A beta. Yes, here dH is the harmonic distortion without feedback, dHf is the harmonic distortion with feedback. Yes, so we said in negative feedback, armor distortion is decreases. How much factor? 1 plus A beta times. So we can tell that dHf equals to how much dH? dH is initially they have given it is 8%. So I am calculating in terms of percentage only. 8%. And 1 plus A beta value is equals to 16.4. So we will get approximately 0.48%. Yes. So the harmonic distortion with the feedback, it is equals to 0.48%. Next, here a feedback amplifier consists of two amplifier blocks in series, each block having a gain of 100. What should be the gain of the feedback block in order to have overall gain is 100? If gain of each amplifier block reduces to 50%, what will be the new overall gain? Yes, so here we need to calculate the beta value. First problem. In second problem, if gain of each amplifier block is reduced to 50%, then what could be the overall gain? Yes, so initially we are calculating the overall gain, it is equals to here A1 and A2, they are cascading. So overall gain can be written as product of the two amplifiers. So each one is 100, the two 100s, 100 into 100 becomes the 10,000. Yes, we can write it is equals to 10 power 4. Yes, this is the overall voltage gain of these two cascaded amplifiers. Yes, so in the problem they have given feedback amplifier gain is also 100. Yes or no? Yes, so they have given the feedback or overall gain equals to 100. We can write it is equals to A by 1 plus A beta. Yes, so can we write 1 plus A beta equals to A by AF? Yes, so A equals to, they are given, it is equals to 10 power 4 and AF equals to 100. So from this we can write it is equals to 100. So 1 plus A beta equals to 100. From this we can write A beta equals to 99. Yes, so from this we can calculate beta equals to 99 by A. So there we calculated the A value is 10 power 4. 99 by 10 power 4, then it is equals to 0.0099. Yes, so the feedback factor is 0.099. That means feedback block gain beta equals to 0.0099. Yes, this is one part. In second part, if gain of each amplifier block reduces to 50%, so now it is 50 into 50, A1 into A2, now it is reduced to 50%, so it is 50 into 50, now it becomes 2500. Yes, so from this, what will be the new overall gain? So it is nothing but AF equals to A by 1 plus A beta. Yes, A equals to 2500 and 1 plus this A equals to 2500 into beta is 0.0099. Yes, from this we will get approximately this value is 97. Yes, so now we calculated the feedback amplifier gain by reducing the each amplifier is 50%. Next we will solve a problem. An amplifier has open loop gain 1000 plus or minus 100. Yes, it is designed to have an amplifier whose gain does not vary by more than plus or minus 0.1%. Calculate the feedback factor and gain with feedback. So they have given the gain is 1000 plus or minus 100. Yes, so how much change? Here we can write A equals to 1000. Yes, change in the A. Yes, change in the open loop gain can be written as plus or minus 100. It is nothing but 10% of A. Can we write? Yes, can we write? So this pressure minus temperature is nothing but change in the open loop gain. So we can write it is equals to 10% of A. Yes. So here we can write variation in gain can be reduced from 10% to 0.1%. Yes. By using negative feedback. That means change in the feedback amplifier gain is equals to plus or minus 0.1%. So we know that change in the feedback amplifier gain is equals to the change in the open loop gain into 1 by 1 plus A beta. We already know this formula. Yes. From this we can write 1 plus A beta equals to dA by A. S dAf by AF. S change in the open loop gain by change in the feedback amplifier gain. S so how much change in the open loop gain? It is 10%. S here feedback gain is changes 0.1%. S can you write it is equals to 100. S so 1 plus A beta equals to 100. From this we can write beta equals to 99 by A. S 99 by A is nothing but here it is equals to 1000. We can write it is equals to 0.099. S from this we need to calculate the here it is beta value, feedback factor beta equals to 0.099. Then gain with feedback can be written as AF equals to A by 1 plus A beta. As A is 1000 here, 1 plus A beta. So 1 plus A beta value is how much? Here it is equals to 100. As 1 plus A beta equals to 100. Then we will get it is equals to 10. So 10 is the feedback amplifier gain. Yes, in this way we can solve the problems on multi-stage amplifiers and feedback amplifiers. Yes, thank you.